Hello, this is Angelo at Arden Jewelers, and today we're talking about white gold versus platinum. This is a question we get all the time, so I'm excited to make a video about it for you. Let's dive right in. To start off, platinum and gold are different elements on the periodic table. Platinum is right about here. And gold is right next to it, here. Gold is naturally yellow, so it's typically combined with nickel or palladium to make it white. These mixtures are normally done in 58 to 75% gold and the rest alloy. More on that later. Platinum, on the other hand, is generally alloyed with ruthenium, or iridium, the budget for this video does not allow us to buy iridium, but like and subscribe, and maybe in the next one we can get it. The mixtures for platinum are typically 90% or more platinum. These fundamental characteristics give these metals different properties. For instance, platinum has a much higher melting point than white gold. Maybe this isn't the most important thing to know, unless you're this guy. But if you're making jewelry, it does really matter.
Ready, fight.
The first difference we're gonna look at is strength. This one is interesting. Platinum beat white gold handily in our deflection test. The platinum wire required about 50% more force to bend to a 45 degree angle than the white gold. However, it took about 20% less force to break the platinum wire than the white gold one in our tensile strength test. Of course, a lot depends on the specific alloy used and how it's been annealed. But the key takeaway here is this. Platinum is going to resist bending a lot more than white gold, where white gold will resist stretching a bit more than platinum. Practically speaking, both metals are more than sufficient for your engagement ring. A platinum prong may hold onto your diamond a bit longer if it's bumped, but either one will fail if you hit your diamond ring hard enough. The best way to fix this is to bring your ring in for regular checkups to your jeweler, as well as taking your ring off for activities where it might hit metal. The main culprits being chores, gardening, dishes, laundry, working out at the gym, or any other activity where you're gonna hit it into something hard like rocks or metal.
Ready, fight.
The next difference is how each metal holds up to daily wear. Throughout the day, our rings take a lot of small bumps, scrapes, and dings. White gold is a harder metal, and when it's scratched, tiny bits of it actually flake off. Platinum, on the other hand, is much softer, and when it's scratched, the surface tends to be pushed around more than it flakes off. This is probably the most practical difference of how the two metals wear. You will typically get more wear out of a platinum ring because of how it acts with the world. Now, does this mean that a white gold ring won't last because a platinum ring will wear longer? No way. I've seen decades old white gold rings that look great. They just need a little more maintenance along the way.
Ready, fight.
You want the jewelry that you wear every day to be comfortable. There are two differences between white gold and platinum that we need to consider here. First, there's the weight. Platinum has a much higher density than white gold. A platinum ring that's the same as a white gold ring will weigh more. Feel how much heavier it is? Oh, wait. Even though the white gold ring is a bit bigger, the platinum one still weighs quite a bit more. Now, this isn't a bad thing, as the extra heft of platinum is typically associated with a higher quality piece of jewelry, but it is good to know. The second difference is important if you think you might have a metal allergy. Platinum is considered hypoallergenic, so it's extremely rare that you would have a reaction to it. Some white gold alloys, on the other hand, are made with nickel, which is the most common metal allergy. So if you are concerned about allergies, make sure you either go with a nickel-free white gold alloy or platinum.
Ready, fight.
The next difference we need to discover is how each metal looks. Day one, they're gonna look very similar, which is partly why it's so hard to choose between them in a jewelry store. Most white gold and some platinum is plated with a very thin layer of the white metal rhodium, which is in the platinum family. That means when rings are brand new, a platinum ring and a white gold ring look very similar. The differences start to show up after the rings have been worn for a few months. Remember that white gold is actually alloyed with a yellow metal.
Gold is naturally yellow.
And some of those alloys are actually a light yellow color underneath of the rhodium. Once the plating wears off, the true color of the metal shows through and the ring needs to be replated to look white again. Now at Arden Jewelers, we prefer to work with level one white gold alloys. These do not need to be re-rhodium plated. However, there are alloys out there that do need to be replated fairly often, and this is one of the main complaints we hear about white gold from our clients. Platinum is not immune to the effects of wear either. Over time, lots of small scratches move the metal around and give it its signature matte gray finish. Some people call it a gunmetal gray finish. This is classic, and if you love that look, platinum's the best way to get it. However, if you want it to be bright and white all the time, we need to polish down the platinum ring, which shortens its time between maintenance. So make sure it's the look you want before you choose platinum. To really show the difference, we made two identical rings. One in platinum, one in white gold. Then a couple of our teammates wore each ring for about 10 months. Let's see how they held up. I will be honest. Before we ran this test, I was expecting to show you how much better the platinum ring wore than the white gold one. That's just the reputation that platinum has. But they both held up so well. I gotta show you this. First off, the platinum ring has a lot more visible scratches due to its softness that we talked about earlier than the white gold ring. Those scratches will eventually lead to that beautiful, dull, matte finish. But as of yet, there's not enough of them to achieve that look yet. It still looks really bright and shiny. Even on day one, the white gold ring had a hint more yellow to it than the platinum ring. That's because it's rhodium plated. By now, that rhodium plating is starting to rub off. And if you're really concerned about your white gold ring looking super white all the time, it's getting close to being in need of replating. However, if it wasn't right next to a platinum ring, I don't think you'd notice yet. And that's just about it. Both rings still look really good. Both are holding their diamond really securely. They're doing their job great.
Ready, fight.
The final difference we're going to look at today is cost. This is a tricky one because there are many factors to it. The first being the metal markets. Historically, platinum has been much higher than gold. And in platinum alloys, we use a lot higher percentage of platinum than in gold alloys. Now, in recent years, the metal markets have gone crazy. Platinum has come down and gold has shot to the moon. Darn banks and auto companies messing with our metal markets. But even with all that, platinum jewelry is still more expensive to buy initially and to work on. Why is that? Partly because of the high melting point, which you talked about earlier, and because every step of the repair process is more time intensive than with gold. Of course, the markets are always changing, but for now at least, in 2025, you are typically going to pay a little bit more for platinum than white gold. So should you buy white gold or platinum? The answer is, it depends. Both are great metals. Typically, a platinum ring will last a little bit longer, but a white gold ring will have a white, shinier look. It really depends on which one you like more and fits better with your lifestyle. As always, if you'd like personalized advice on which metal is best for you, reach out to us anytime. We'd love to help you decide and make you a beautiful ring in the process. Thanks for watching. Now, will a white gold ring not last as long as a platinum run? The second difference is important to know if you think you have Feel free to reach out to us anytime if you'd like personalized advice on how to make a beautiful ring. That makes no sense. Platinum beat white gold in this first test. Deflection test.